Movies are projects of passion. They are large collaborations of hundreds of artisans that bring their talents for full display to the public. But these artists do not set out with the intent of making something of poor quality. This is why I take great joy in defending or fixing bad movies. But sometimes, there is a film or franchise that is so terrible that it's best to let it burn in the dumpster from which it came. Reputably Rubbish presents Why Twilight Cannot Be Fixed. I want you to know that I have read all the books and watched all the movies. The first time I attempted to watch the third movie, I was filled with such a hatred of my high school days that I felt a great sense of relief that the DVD had a scratch and my DVD player made the decision for me not to finish the film. I have, however, rewatched every Mothra damned movie for this video. The experience was, like these movies, awful. I hope you appreciate my sacrifice for your entertainment. Let it be known that in concept, a vampire-human romance with werewolves, secret societies, and the complexities therein has a lot of potential. So put on your water wings, it's time to dive in. The good elements. This shot is brilliant and adequately depicts the emotion of a difficult breakup. Billy Burke's Charlie feels and acts like an actual loving father struggling to connect with and protect his daughter. Despite Michael Sheen only having limited screen time as the head of the Volturi, his devouring of the scenery is downright hypnotic. And finally, Anna Kendrick's Jessica Stanley feels like the only real character in the movie. These movies should have been comedies following her around as she's trying to understand what the hell is going on. Unfortunately, that's it. Acting. There are no small roles, only small actors. This is made clear by the screen thief herself, that is Anna Kendrick. But given the accomplished performances of Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart, I mark their hollow, shallow performances up to being given hollow, shallow material to start with. Given the filmography of several of their co-stars, I cannot extend this benefit of doubt to their acting abilities. Plot. Remember what I said about the good plot foundation of the human vampire romance with a sprinkling of werewolf and a dash of secret society for zest? Smother that with a pink lacy pillow of boring melodrama. The plot centered on unrealistic, shallow, on-again, off-again love triangles, while ignoring the side plot potentialities, suck the lifeblood out of the central story. Unfortunately, this is also true of the source material. Anna Kendrick's character being confused about Edward and Bella's attraction to one another was the best part of the movie, and it was also oddly relatable. Production design. I understand that it rains a lot in Washington State. I understand that direct sunlight do weird things to vampires, but washed out dreary color palette combined with the boring plot is the perfect cure for insomnia. Except for you, Anna Kendrick, you're a ray of sunshine. Music. The movie studio was more focused on teen bop album sales than emotional impact. Copies of the soundtrack are readily available at garage sales and thrift stores. Hey, you know who can sing? Direction. In the hands of a skilled director, a difficult script, challenging actors, and production issues can result in great filmmaking. I get that subtle shaky cam is a staple of early 2000s movies, but there does come a point where it's downright nauseating. You know who can direct? Characters. Now would be the time to like, comment, and subscribe, because I'm about to lose my shit. You can have an amazing world with a fascinating culture, but if you populate that world with dull, shallow people, you will get a dull, shallow story. Each actor embodies, as well as they can, the material they are given. Robert Pattinson plays Edward as a boring creeper because Edward Cullen is a boring creeper. Kristen Stewart plays Bella as an empty husk of an emo stereotype because she's written as an empty husk of an emo stereotype. Taylor Lautner plays Jacob as a culturally appropriated stereotype with hormone control issues because, well, all of that. And he can't act. These base elements are bad, but not the worst parts. It's what the characters do to drive the plot that crosses into unforgivable territory. You see, I described Edward as a creeper, akin to the guy at Starbucks who, while sitting completely across the coffee shop from you, keeps eyeing you up and makes you uncomfortable. Well, that guy doesn't fucking show up in your bedroom to watch you in your fucking sleep! Edward isn't a monster because he's a vampire, he's a monster because he's a fucking stalker. Jacob is actually worse. He may come across as a harmless himbo, but he forces his advances onto Bella despite her denying him flat out. He can't have Bella, so he imprints on her infant daughter. If you say, "Oh, but there's a line of dialogue where Jacob says, it's not like that." Well, then I would like to remind you that earlier they showed couples that have imprinted on each other making out on the beach. Bullshit, Jacob. It's exactly fucking like that. This is all without even looking at how both Edward and Jacob tried to control Bella at all times in all of the movies. These are the fucking heroes. In what morally depraved pit of Carcosa is any of this okay? Final thoughts. Despite all of the issues that I have mentioned, and none of them have been a secret, the largest problem is this. Stalking, child grooming, abusive codependency, and assault are all elements of true life horror. These elements of horror are not only normalized, yet worse, they are actually, literally, being romanticized and marketed to a narrow demographic of teenage girls and young women who are now given an abusive series of relationships to idolize. I'm not saying the books nor films should be banned or boycotted, but I would challenge you this. Point out the flaws to anyone who views these relationships as normal or healthy. The books and films are so bad, they cannot be defended or fixed. Worse yet, they don't deserve either. I understand that after my rant, this may be a bit odd to hear, but with the world being as messed up as it is, we need to look out for one another, and especially ourselves. Please, give yourself and others patience, compassion, and grace. And remember, Anna Kendrick, you are a fucking national treasure.
Thank you for watching this talkie picture. Please leave a message down below, select the like picture, and subscribe to be a member of our community. Thank you.